just, I understand, got out of jail.
Well, I feel a real short time for the last couple of years. Virtually 6 months.
What?
Federal trespass. A lot of that has been down in Georgia, you know, California, you know, the Fort Payne. That's where we were able to do that. And got for trespass 6 months. Got it locked for federal prison in California.
So, tell me, do you expect to get arrested this week?
I don't know. I didn't actually. I think I have an honorary degree in CTU, Capitalism, on Friday, so I have to kind of be around here for that. So you made a big commitment around that.
So
I don't know if I'll be able to stay after that. I would have probably done it if I'd gotten here. Day before I would have done it yesterday, but I just have to see what this is.
So at CTU, you're doing what? You're getting an honorary doctorate.
So I mean, so that's one reason I had to come to here, but then that's complicated.
Congratulations to you.
Well, I
imagine you have a lot of degrees.
Well, the only reason is we've got to get the word out. We've got to get the word out. We have to save the planet, save the world. We've got to take seriously this world that God gave us, and Jesus says, love your enemies, love your neighbors, love everyone, because we're all created by God. We're all created to live together. I'm talking to people of every stripe, every kind, religiously. I'm very good friends with Muslims. I can do Ramadan every year. In fact, I give you a ring. Palestine, Israel. So I believe in a world in which everybody kind of loves each other. There's no reason that all this works. We're spending $1 trillion on nuclear weapons and all that. The prison I was in Vancouver, right in back of it, they were setting off these huge satellites to run the drones and everything, and then missiles to test them all the way out to the Roger Lane, where we set up the H-bomb and filling it up with depleted uranium and all that. They take the war in it, they're going to work it out.
You're going to be here tomorrow, right?
Tomorrow here.
You going to be in Chicago tomorrow?
I will be in Chicago.
Real quick, well, I'll get it last. I'm going to get your phone number last. But, so when did you first start your activism? How old were you?
I was in the Air Force.
How many years? Oh, really? You were
in the Air Force.
Interesting life.
College, yeah.
So you started at 25 or 30, and how old? I'm just trying to get how many years you've been doing this. How many? How old are you?
I am 79.
So you're almost 80. You've been protesting. You first got arrested 50 years ago.
Yeah.
And hundreds of times, literally more than 200 people probably. Okay.
There's a lot of different, you know, in the Vietnam War, civil rights movement, the farm movement, very close to Central Chocolate. A lot of draft resistance during the Vietnam War. Then I went to Nevada and still doing draft resistance and welfare mothers. I'm getting arrested. I got the first arrest on that. So I'm closing this trip. Welfare mothers, because half of them have been thrown off, presumed fraud, etc. Then that was kind of, these things were sort of dying down. They said, yeah, the crime trace is building up. Well, what happened to you there right outside of Las Vegas? So that test site, so we started getting, I got there over 100 times right at the end. So that's what we did get, word for senior, to put a moratorium on when we're going to test it the other day. So then I moved from that to other, you know, nuclear issues. And a lot of,
so what would make these protests successful for you?
When I got my doctorate, I studied social movements. Social movements happen. People believe that things don't happen. It shouldn't be this way, and then they don't have to go this way. People that are oppressed, vote, jobs, people being locked up in prisons, you know, and so people get together, and at first it becomes chaotic. I work in a different with the Occupy movement, and there's some chaotic stuff that goes down. There are young people, tremendously good people, making this new company makers. Most of us come out of some kind of spiritual activity. You know, the sword, Peter, and you'll die by the sword. And I come from a Sicilian family.
All right, last question. We're about done. I know he's probably getting tired of holding it, but this is interesting. For folks that are at home thinking, you know, they might care about these issues. For folks folks that are thinking, I'm interested, what would you say to them to get them to come out and join you in the streets?
Well, one of the things that I think that people need to look at is, where am I? What's going on with me? How are my kids doing? Well, my kids can't get into college. But community college in the best schools like that, California, takes 10 years to get out. You can make it get in, start paying fees, and you'll keep paying fees, and then all of a sudden, there will be, you know, you can't get enough classes to get out. California schools, tuition, so skyrocketing. That was a graduate school.
Well, the folks that...
So, I mean, see in your own case, you're keeping your job, you have your peers, a house, et cetera. How about your kids? How are they doing? I mean, the 90+% of the people are having a tough time, and they're scared. They're worried for their kids, they're worried for themselves. Get together. It's supposed to be a democracy. You're supposed to work together. We know who calls the shots in there. You know, the multi-billionaires. They don't even live here.
Okay.
So get together. We can change here. It's changed before. There's nonviolent transformation going on all over the world. From the time of Gandhi and Martin Luther King and all the countries of Eastern Europe. All those dictatorships fell, and the same thing in Latin America. Through nonviolence. And that's what he said. That's what Jesus said. Martin said. King said. So that's why I'm here. I don't want to go to prison. You know, I'm a priest. I minister to people. If they're in prison, that's just...
You're almost 80. In your life, how many years have you spent behind bars?
Oh, I don't know. You know, one or two or something like that. But most of these things, you don't... You don't see the sentences here. Nothing.
But it's been worth it to you.
Absolutely.
Yeah. You're putting yourself on the line.
It's all right.
You're free to leave for a while.
I'm free in prison, too. Because I follow my conscience and follow my Lord. I'm very happy with that, and I'll keep doing it as long as I'm out there.
All right, thanks a lot. You were really good. I appreciate it.
It's a great country. I love this country.
It's a...